Archaeology falls under the major of anthropology, which is the study of all aspects of humankind and their approach to the concept of culture. So archaeology is the study of people and the past based off their things. When doing archaeology on the forts, circle plots, you realize the things people used to do when fighting during the Civil War battle. We found out through archaeology research and that some of these forts, circle plots used to have and contraband camp. The first national park was established in 1872. The reason why it is important to preserve national park, Civil War defenses of Washington and the Southern, because all of these places has a significant importance to the American culture and to protect the wildlife that exists within these areas. The impacts that come from these national parks and other parks that are owned by the National Park Service is that it preserves history so others can learn and gain from different perspectives and to know how this country has evolved since its establishment, but also to enjoy the scenery and landscape. Did you know that there were national parks in the District of Columbia other than the National Mall and the Memorial Parks? Did you know that there were Civil War defenses in the District of Columbia?
Did you know that there were national parks in the District of Columbia other than the National Mall and Memorial Parks?
Yes, I knew.
Which ones did you know?
I've heard about Fort DuPont.
What did you know about Fort DuPont?
All I know is that every summer Fort DuPont holds special events in the park.
Did you know that there were Civil War defenses in the District of Columbia?
No, I didn't know the Civil War came up this far. I thought it was more.
Many people haven't heard of Fort Chapman, Fort DuPont, or Fort Mahan because they are often neglected because of the area it is in. Most of the residents that live east of the Anacostia is African American. Many people think that the community surrounding east of the Anacostia doesn't care, but in actuality they do. I too live by Fort Chapman Park, apartments near Fort Mahan and Fort Chapman, and I truly do care about the Civil War defenses of Washington. Once you tell the community of minorities about the history behind Fort Chapman, Fort Mahan, or even Fort DuPont, it becomes a significant importance to African Americans. The Civil War at first was fought for state rights, because in the South they wanted slavery to continue, but in the North they wanted slavery to end. When South Carolina seceded and attacked Fort Sumter, President Lincoln knew that if the country was to be reunited again, slavery had to cease from existing within the United States. Many residents don't know that the Civil War came this far north because most of the Civil War happened in the South, but it did. When I first heard about there being a Civil War fort in the District of Columbia, I was fascinated and surprised by it. I never realized that the Civil War came to the District of Columbia because when taking United States history in the 11th grade and learning about the Civil War, they never explained that Fort Stevens in Washington, D.C. saw action and contributed to protecting the White House. Even though some of these forts didn't see action, that means they was doing their jobs correctly by protecting the White House, so we wouldn't have to see a relapse of the War of 1812 when the British burned down the White House. So to me, protecting and preserving the Civil War forts is extremely important because maybe my ancestors fought for my freedom, and to have it destroyed by erosion, being polluted by trash and toxins, and the lack of maintenance would truly be disappointing because people lived there, fought there, and sacrificed their lives to have a better country and to fight for a change.